This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about the rules for addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division of positive and negative numbers. So let's start with addition. First problem I have is 5 plus 3. Both of these are positive numbers, and the rule for addition says that if both the numbers are positive, then the result, the sum, will be positive. So 5 plus 3 is going to equal 8. Now, if both the signs are negative, like in the next problem, negative 2 plus negative 5, I'm going to add the 2 and the 5 together, but the result will be negative. So that's going to be negative 7. So if the signs are both positive, the sum is positive. If the signs are both negative, the sum is negative. Now, when we get to situations where one sign is positive and one sign is negative, we have to work this a bit differently. If we have different signs, like positive 5 plus negative 9, here's what we do. We look at just the numbers without the signs. We look at the 5 and the 9. And we take the difference between those two numbers. So the difference between 5 and 9 is 4. Okay, 9 minus 5 is 4. So our answer is going to have a 4. We have to decide whether it's positive or negative. We're going to look at the two numbers again. Whichever number was bigger, we're going to use the sign that that number had. So 9 is bigger than 5, and the 9 was negative. So the answer is going to be negative 4. Once again, if the signs are different, take the difference of the two numbers, disregarding their signs, and then look at the two numbers, whichever number was bigger, use the sign that that number had for your answer. Here's another one. I've got negative 4 plus 7. So the signs are different. I'm going to take the difference of 4 and 7. The difference of 4 and 7 is 3. And now I have to decide what sign that'll have. Well, 7 is bigger than 4, and 7 is positive. So my answer will be positive. It'll be a positive 3. Okay, so that's basically how addition works. Now, subtraction is going to be easy once you understand addition. So here I've got 6 minus 10. What I'm going to do with this is turn it into an addition problem. Here's how. I'm going to write the 6, and then this, since this was a subtraction problem, I'm going to do the opposite of subtraction, which is addition. So I've got 6 plus. Now, to compensate for doing the opposite of subtraction, I'm going to take the opposite of the number I was subtracting. I was subtracting a 10, and the opposite of 10 is negative 10. So now what I've got is 6 plus negative 10. I took the opposite of subtraction and made it addition. I took the opposite of 10 and made it negative 10. Now I've got an addition problem. 6 plus negative 10. Well, the signs are different. So I'm going to take the difference between those two numbers, 6 and 10. The difference is 4. 10 was the larger number, and it's negative. So my answer is going to be negative 4. Here's another one. I've got 8 minus negative 5. So I'm going to take that subtraction problem. I'll make it addition. I'll make it an addition problem by turning that into 8 plus, and I want the opposite of negative 5, since I've done the opposite of subtraction. The opposite of negative 5 would be positive 5. So now all I've got is 8 plus 5. 8 plus 5 is 13, and that's it. Okay, now we're ready for multiplication. Multiplication has different rules than addition and subtraction. If both the signs are the same, the product of multiplication will be positive. So if I have 3 times 2, both of those are positive numbers. So 3 times 2 is 6. Then I've got negative 4 times negative 3. If both the signs are the same, and they are, they're both negative, the product will be positive. So this is going to be positive, and it's going to be 4 times 3, which is 12. Okay, so if both the signs are positive or both the signs are negative, your product will be positive. If the signs are different, the product will be negative. So if I have negative 2 times positive 5, that's going to be negative 10. If I have 6 times negative 3, the signs are different, that's going to be negative 18. So once again, for multiplication, if the signs are the same, the product is positive. If the signs are different, the product is negative. Now, the rules for multiplication are going to be the same rules we're going to see for division. So here I've got division. I've got 6 divided by 2. The signs are both positive, 6 and 2, positive 6 and positive 2. So the result, the quotient, 6 divided by 2, is going to be a positive 3. Then I've got negative 8 divided by negative 4. The signs are the same. Just as in multiplication, if the signs are the same, my answer is going to be positive. So negative 8 divided by negative 4 is going to be a positive 2. Now, if the signs are different, we do the same thing we did with multiplication. If the signs are different, the result will be negative. The quotient will be negative. So negative 10 divided by 2 is negative 5. We just divide 10 by 2 and make the result negative. 12 divided by negative 4, the signs are different. So that means the quotient is going to be negative, and 12 divided by 4 is 3. Okay, so those are your basic rules for adding, subtracting, multiplying, and dividing positive and negative numbers. Take care. I'll see you next time.